Hi, penguins. Today we are going to learn about the different spaces you can create to work in your home. These spaces will help you read, work, and find places to chill and keep yourself happy at home. You could create different spaces or have one space that does all of this.
Hi, penguins. This is Mrs. Hamill. I miss you guys so much, and I hope that you are staying safe and healthy at home and having a good time. I will see you soon, hopefully. Today, I want to talk to you about finding a spot in your house where you can read. So I made a little chart, and this chart says, readers find a spot in their home where they can read. So there's a few things I want you to ask yourself when you're trying to find a spot in home at home when you read. So first ask yourself, is the spot you're going to find comfortable? When I try to find the spot in my house to read, I like to find, and I'll show you my spot. I like to find a spot that has pillows and I can relax like this. I also like to read at night when everybody's asleep and nobody will interrupt me. So if that's you, you might want to find a real quiet spot. So on my list of questions, I ask myself, is my spot quiet? But you might be able to read with lots of noise going on. Might want to put on some headphones. I also like to cover up with a blanket. The next step, when you find your reading spot at home, you need to get your books. I have my book right here next to my reading spot. And finally, last step, start reading. So penguins, once you find your reading spot, you can do many things in your reading spot. Mrs. Cahoe is going to talk about other things you can do in your reading spot, like some mindful techniques or some belly breathing. All right, go ahead, Miss Cahoe.
Thanks, Mrs. Hamill. So we created a reading spot that's comfy and cozy and allows you to focus on reading. You can also use that spot when you need some quiet, alone time. So we're going to talk about creating a zen zone or a chill zone or a calm down spot just for you at your house. The first thing we need to do is to find a space where we can chill. That space is quiet and it could be in a little corner pushed off to the side. When we are in that space, we are letting our family know that we need some time to ourselves. The next thing we do is make that space comfy. We can add pillows and blankets and different comfy things. The next thing we do is add things that we love. These things make us smile and comfort us in that space. We could add pictures or books that we love, or even some music to listen to our favorite songs. Sometimes our songs help us stay calm and relax. The last thing we can do is add things that will help us in our quiet space. This is when we add those tools that'll help us calm. So we could add a teddy bear to squeeze that'll help us calm down. Some rainbows for rainbow breathing or any other breathing tools you use. Think about when you're in your classroom, you might use a calm down bottle or different calming tools. What spaces do you need to be successful at home? Let's check out some spaces from our other penguin teachers.